this is Rickie. Rickie is a broken black, New Zealand. He is, unlike every other New Zealand on the place, he is not pedigreed. Doesn't mean we love him any less. It does mean that we probably won't be breeding anything from him. Not too many people desire a New Zealand as a pet because they get so big. And as you can see, Rickie is molting badly. And he has been, looks like him and one of his cellmates has got into a peeing contest. And I'm not sure if he's the winner or the loser. Francis, if you're watching, you're buffering. Your little Max has been peeing all over Rick. He's just been an unruly, nasty little boy. But anyway, this is Rickie. Like I said, unpedigreed, but the gentleman I mentioned earlier, the same guy, Northern Ohio Rabbitry, David Pitts, this is his first rabbit. The first rabbit that he ever owned. Rickie's about 4 years old. And, you know, Rickie's just kind of special. And, you know, he's looking nasty now, but we will get that whipped into shape. He's going to get all this fur blown out. We said that we would take Rickie and we would give him a home. Love him and play with him and all that kind of stuff. We had considered allowing him the option of becoming a free-range bunny around here. The only problem is I don't know how that would work out. You know, we've got Jazz running loose. Now Jazz thinks he runs the rabbitry. He runs the barnyard, okay? And I just don't want these guys fighting. So I don't know if we're gonna go that route. I would like to see, you know, Rickie, you know, with a horse, we'd call it putting him out to pasture, you know, but I think he would be happy as a free range bunny. But I just don't want him to end up having to be out here fighting Jazz all the time because Jazz thinks the place is his. So I don't know. I don't know if we, you know, if we let him down. I don't know. Really, he seems tame and everything, and he likes to be pampered and petted. But once he got down on the ground, I just don't know, especially after he's been a day or two out, I just don't know how he would be wanting us to catch him again. So we might have some difficulty there. So I don't know. We've got kind of mixed ideas about what's in Rickie's future. He's not going to be culled or anything like that, okay? He's a baby, okay? He's a retired bunny, to say the least, okay? Not nothing like that. We're gonna hang on to him. Here you go, right there on the, there, I got it. Now, some rabbits don't like this, but as you can see, when I go through here and I'm plucking this loose fur out, you see Rickie doesn't have it. And it actually makes him feel better. But see here, see how nasty. See how that fur sticks up? That should be nice, pretty flyback fur. And it will be once this is all gone. See, this is all nasty dead fur. And once that is all gone and nice pretty new fur has grown back in, it will be nice and beautiful and flyback. See, he's got it. See? Okay, but this is Rickie. He's a pet bunny. He was originally bought and kept as a breeder for a meat producing, for producing meat. Just strictly a meat producing line. He doesn't have wind getting worse. He doesn't have any of that. You know, he's not a fancy show bunny. but we are not in the business right now of breeding anything just for the purpose of meat. You know, once we get all of our New Zealand red does and what have you going, we are going to have enough in that in out of those litters that are not going to be showable, that's going to have obvious DQs and so on and so forth, that we're going to have plenty of meat for the freezer, okay? Even after hanging on to rabbits that we want to show and having breeding stock for sale, we're still going to have plenty, okay? We just got to get everybody in full swing, okay? We're up to, sis, what are we up to now? 7 or 8?
What?
If we, once we get them all breeding, man, we up to like 7 or 8 does now?
I think so.
New Zealand? Well, I think so. I was counting Tater, though, and she's still kind of young.
Yeah, she's still kind of young. Marcy.
But anyway, yeah, we'll have some does going, and then hopefully by spring, I think Tater, she might be able to produce some babies with somebody, and then throw us some more broken babies. We've got grubs, but so far with the does that I've had, with the exception of Tater, the one doe out of Annabelle, all the rest of them have been heavy brokens. And I don't like those. I don't prefer those. It's something we got to put up with, but I want to kind of get to the point where we can have some more lightly broken. Maybe not as light as Rickie. I don't know, Rickie might be genetically a Charlie. I don't know, I've never seen any of his babies. But he's definitely a lightly pattern broken. Anyway, they say if all the color on their back or on their body, if you could push it, if it'll all fit on their head, that they're a Charlie. They say if you pushed all this black together and it would all fit on their head, they say that's a Charlie. I don't know, it'd be close, wouldn't it? See, he don't have much of a nose marking. Have a whole lot in between his eyes. Most brokens, a lot of brokens, got color all the way down from the ear base and then it goes around the eyes too. So, oh well, you don't matter, does you, buddy? Doesn't matter as long as you love me. Yeah, we may, I don't know. If he'll molt some of this nasty fur right here out, we may let him go to the fair. Who knows? Who knows? It doesn't matter. We let the kids take the bunnies to the fair. You know, it's all in fun. Some of the parents get a little bit too competitive. And in doing so, they teach their children poor sportsmanship. That's not what we're trying to do. We're trying to teach them good sportsmanship, but we're also trying to teach them that, you know, whether you win, whether you have success or failure at the show, is largely dependent on how much work you're willing to put into the project. You're a good boy, Rickie. You're a good boy, Rickie.
He's a sweetheart.
He is a tattooed bunny. No pedigree. That's all right. We don't need a pedigree. We know how old he is. He's a good boy, though. Many of you folks around close by have got does. He could cover some does if you had him. You were just keeping him for meat production or something. But I don't want to get rid of him. But I would let him. I would let. I mean, you could use him for breeding. But you know, you'd have to be. You'd have to be pretty well here in town, or willing to come here. Rickie wouldn't mind. He loves your ladies. All right, folks. I guess this is pretty well. Now, Becca, do we have any more new additions? Okay, well, we appreciate y'all sticking around to the end of this new edition video. I know we get boring and what have you, but you know, we haven't brought you no videos in couple of weeks, and then we come out here and we try to shoot a bunch on one day, and it's hard to remember everything that we were going to try to include in a video, you know. So we will, and you know, when we shoot videos and we've got videos what I call in the tank, which is some that I can upload and edit or whatever and get ready to go live or go to be published, I usually, what I do is if you see a video today, in 2 days, if I've got another one done, in 2 days you'll see another one. I've been trying, you know, when I've got videos in the tank ready to be published, to where you guys can see them, I usually do that every couple of days. And so if you're watching this video today, which you've probably already seen a couple that we filmed today, by the time we get to this one, I don't know what order I'm going to upload them in. I never do, but probably you've already seen something from today. And if we haven't already showed them all to you, we'll probably get back with you in a couple of days. So we appreciate y'all watching this New Zealand edition of additions to the rabbit edition of additions to the rabbit tree. Y'all, we'd appreciate it, folks. Y'all subscribe, ring that little bell so you get our notifications when we're posting something new. Love to have you watch everything. You know, most of our videos nowadays are rabbit related. We've got to get some materials together. And a little bit of that nasty green stuff they call fundulation. We've got some more work we're going to do to the rabbit tree thing. I don't know if we call that a building, but it's something over there that we're calling a rabbit tree. We're going to do some more work on that. We've got stuff. We're going to put in an automatic watering system, but we're going to do it different than we did before. We're actually going to be using the brass watering nozzles, nipples, whatever you want to call them, and we're going to be using PVC pipe. So, which means we're going to hopefully rule out the idea of having algae in our drinking water for our rabbits. So that'll be a good thing. And brass nozzles, although they cost a little more up front, they are also easier to maintain. They don't get clogged and wear out as easy. But instead of like the old cheap ones that we have now that are like $1, $1.25 a piece, $1.50, when they go bad, chunk them and you got to put in another one. These right here, you can take them apart with a wrench, and there's a couple of little plastic pieces in there that you can replace for like 50 cents. And you're rebuilding the water nozzle and making it just like new again. So you pay $3 for them up front, but then you can rebuild them over and over and over and over indefinitely as opposed to throwing them away and getting a new one. Something that we're gonna try. I think it's worthy. I've got what we need to set up 10 cages with that type of system right now. And we're gonna show you basically everything we're gonna do to install that. We're gonna start off feed it from a 5 gallon bucket, fill the bucket with a hose like we do on the other two buildings. But then we're gonna, hopefully down the road, we're gonna install some type of a float type system that we can either connect PVC directly to, or that we can just connect a hose up to, so that we can use that float to keep that bucket full 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And then we might even look into some heating solutions so that we can keep all that stuff freezing up the bucket so we can use it all winter long. You know, it doesn't get that cold here in the winter, but we do have some cold nights. And ordinarily, we drain our automatic watering system for, I don't know, about a month or so out of the winter, and then water everybody out of crocks. And that's a crock. We don't like doing that. It's a crock, having the water out of the crocks. So we're going to try to get away from that. But to do that, we have to make it possible to keep it from freezing in the winter. Because PVC, if you ever seen water freezing that stuff, yeah, it's going to shatter, splinter, and all that good stuff. So. Hey, we got some stuff to come. We hope you're interested in seeing that. We're we're going to try to video and document what we can and share as much of it as we can with you. So until then, y'all have a great day and God bless.